Hi there, this is Dr. Paul Fernhaber, and it's time for 10 Minutes of Truth because it's Wednesday. So today I have another article that I want to go over. I think you're going to find this one interesting. I think probably you find most of my articles interesting, but this is one that people have talked about these issues for years, but this is the first study I've ever seen that really investigated it. The name of the study is called Associations Between Weather Conditions and Osteoarthritis Pain, a Systematic Review and Meta-Analysis. And it was published in the Annals of Medicine, April of 2023, so April of last year. So it's fairly recent, less than a year old. This article looked at 14 studies. 11 were considered high quality studies, 2 were high quality case crossover studies, and 1 of the studies they considered a lower quality study. But this is the first study that investigated the association between osteoarthritis pain and weather conditions. Now, it focused on the relationship between things like barometric pressure, precipitation, relative humidity, hours of sunshine, and temperature. So I see this a lot in practice. My mother tells me the same thing. You know, I can predict the weather by how I feel. I can predict the weather changes by my neck pain or my knee pain or my arm pain or whatever. And people come into me and they say, you know, you may think I'm crazy, but. And then they tell me that. Well, guess what? They're not crazy, okay? So let's just talk about osteoarthritis for just a minute. The predominant symptom of osteoarthritis is pain, and the signature pathologic issue is loss of cartilage. So there's widespread and frequent assertion that osteoarthritis pain is influenced by the weather. And so if we look at the background of this study, and this is an actual study, but it's background, an early European study reported that 67% of participants with osteoarthritic pain attributed their pain to the weather. A recent study has demonstrated an association of weather sensitivity and clinical symptoms and structural degradations in knee osteoarthritis patients. Now, this next one is really interesting. A double-blind study that was done of 4 osteoarthritis patients who were placed in a climatized room for 2 weeks with controlled barometric pressure, temperature, and relative humidity. Here's what they found in this study. The simultaneous variations of relative humidity and pressure affected arthritis symptoms. Another study found that 83% of arthritic patients were sensitive to changes in temperature, barometric pressure, and precipitation, which may aggravate osteoarthritic symptoms. So in this study, what they found is that barometric pressure was positively related to our osteoarthritic pain. So that means that, you know, when a front comes through and the pressure changes and people feel that in their bodies, that this is not something they're imagining, that it's real. Relative humidity was positively related to the pain. So when the humidity changes, so, you know, if it gets less, it gets quite a bit less in the winter, quite a bit more in the summer, and people feel these changes in their body. This is real. It says there is strong evidence with 13 of the 14 studies reported consistent findings that weather factors in general, including any kind of meteorological condition, were associated with osteoarthritis pain. Temperature, relative humidity, and blood pressure were the most frequent weather factors related to the osteoarthritis pain. Temperature, relative humidity, and blood pressure were the most frequent weather factors related to knee osteoarthritic pain. There's moderate evidence that hip osteoarthritis pain was influenced by barometric pressure. Now that's interesting because the hip pain was not necessarily as sensitive to humidity and temperature, but it was sensitive to barometric pressure. So the conclusion of this study is this, is that weather factors really do influence osteoarthritic pain. So if you are one of those people that can predict the weather by how you feel and how your joints feel, what you're feeling is real. It's not your imagination. And so this is a study, the first study I've ever seen, that I've ever read, that verifies that. So what is that exactly? Where does that leave you? Well, it is theorized that injured tissue heals with varying amounts of scar tissue. So is arthritic tissue injured tissue? Of course it is. Whether it's injured through wear and tear or injured through an accident. Scar tissue always maintains an inflammatory response, sometimes forever, which alters the pain threshold. So tissue that's injured is trying to heal with scar tissue, and scar tissue is always weaker and always more pain sensitive than normal tissue. Now, when this is adjusted, when specific line of drive adjustments remodel the scar tissue, reducing its ability to hold an inflammatory response, those issues with pain and weather may diminish or even go away. So that's what I have for today. If you have arthritic pain and the weather is aggravating it, you may want to try chiropractic. Okay, that may be able to help you. And if not, then if you don't want to try chiropractic, then you can go on predicting the weather with your joints. So this is Dr. Fernhaber. We're here at 4535 Normal Boulevard in Lincoln, Nebraska. Our phone number is 402-488-2220. If you want to get in touch with us, we'd love to come have you come in and talk to us about any health issues that you may be experiencing. Otherwise, we will be in touch next week. See you then.